Now from so many months in space, and they need to take a break. The landing party has been down to check out the terrain while the crew gets ready to play. They say there's only plant life living on this lovely rock, but a rodent appears wearing a vest, followed by a blonde girl with a terrible accent, but at least she gave it her best. Kirk's tricked by Spock. Weapons are hidden under rocks. Sulu shoots a handgun without warning anyone that they might want to stay out of the way. It's amazing how quickly Angela seems to have moved on after the death of her fiancé. She seems so relaxed here that she would not even guess that he died in the last episode. Tells Bones about his days in the academy, then he runs into an old foe. Yeoman Barrow screams, Don Juan is not just a dream. I sure want to leave. I think you'd agree. Appears from nowhere and she has an ancient day. I think she might be a salt vampire. She might also have the Venus drug, cause Kirk can't seem to think. He's so distracted by her. It's a good thing the antenna didn't hear what McCoy said, or there'd be armies of Don Juans around. Sulu sees a samurai and then runs into Kirk. They figure out the phasers are down. Then Spock beams down. They're trapped until they can figure it. Against a knight on a black horse, he says that it can't hurt him. But then he goes down in seconds, and then Kirk shoots the black knight. It's too late, he's dead, Jim. Someone steals the bodies, and then Finnegan appears. They get into a brawl. Kirk orders a team to concentrate on standing still and don't think of anything at all. Some dude walks out, proceeds to explain what it's all about. I sure want to leave. I think you'd agree, but we cannot leave till just an amusement park. Bones is now alive, so it's okay for him to say, I'm a doctor, not a shish kebab. Apparently it's okay if we trust an unknown race who can read any one of our thoughts. So be careful what you wish for in this land of dreams come true.